So this is a cool technique I was just inspired to create by a request on GitHub using DuckDB on the back end as well as DuckDB on the front end, DuckDB WASM. So this first cell here uses the DuckDB backend, that is the native DuckDB, to query some data set defined remotely and saves it into this Apple variable. So this ends up being cached as a JSON file and exposed in the notebook as a JavaScript variable, which you can see here. And then what I'm doing is creating a DuckDB client. So this is a client-side now database running with DuckDB WASM, and it exposes that same Apple data set. So the idea is you could fetch some data remotely, maybe reduce it, maybe bring it down into some reasonable size, aggregate it, and now you can query it dynamically in the client. To demonstrate that, I'm gonna create a view. And so this is basically a dynamic table that I want to query. In this case, this query is defined as the top days, the days with the largest trading volume according to some limit, currently set to 500. And then down here in this last table, I'm querying this top days table and showing the results. Here I'm grouping it by day of week and just showing the count. Now, the cool thing is this is all defined reactively. So if I drag this limit slider here, you can see I'm reducing the number of days that are counted, and it's pretty much instantaneous because DuckDB is able to redefine these views very quickly. It doesn't have to, you know, reload the data or anything like that. It's very fast. And maybe one last thing I'll demonstrate is that in order to query from this dynamically created view, we're using this helper function or built-in function called query table, which lets us pass in the top day's name dynamically. So it's kind of an interesting technique because it lets you define all of your data transforms in SQL, but you still get all of the benefits of reactivity. So a lot of power there, pretty exciting.